Good morning from Mission Control Houston, and welcome to this Friday edition of International Space Station Update. The crew of Expedition 32, in their final week as a six-person crew on board the orbiting laboratory, three of the astronauts there on the right will be departing the International Space Station this upcoming Sunday. We'll start all the way over on the right there with Russian cosmonaut Sergei Revin on his first space flight. And then to the left is Expedition 32 commander and another Russian cosmonaut, Gennady Padalka, and then NASA astronaut Joe Acaba. And moving across the back row, we have NASA astronaut Sonny Williams, who will be taking over command of the International Space Station on Saturday. And then Russian cosmonaut Yuri Malenchenko and Japanese astronaut Aki Hoshide will remain on board with her as they transition from Expedition 32 over to Expedition 33. So it's been a very busy week for these astronauts on board the International Space Station with a slew of vehicle activity with the departure of an unmanned cargo craft and the imminent departure of that Soyuz craft carrying three of our astronauts back down to the ground. In addition to all that, the regular maintenance and experiment work that consumes much of these astronauts' time. So we'll start off on Monday, where NASA astronaut Joe Acaba was doing a fit check on the entry suit that he'll be wearing when he departs the International Space Station in his Soyuz TMA-04M vehicle. You can actually see that entry suit in this photo. It's the it's a Russian Sokol suit that protects the astronauts during all of their dynamic vehicle activities. So he was doing some fit checks and leak checks on that suit, and also packing a few items inside of the Soyuz craft for return. In addition to that, he was reviewing all of the robotic procedures for the upcoming release of the Japanese HTV-3 vehicle, which took place on Wednesday. Moving on, Sonny Williams woke up in the morning and immediately went into some biological research activities. She was working with the human research facility, taking some blood and urine samples, and then storing them inside of the Melfi, which is the minus 80 degree laboratory freezer for ISS. It's one of the cryogenic freezers on board the station that is used to store and keep the integrity of biological samples intact before they can be transferred down to researchers on the ground. In addition to that, she was working on the VO2 max experiment, which looks to document any changes in the maximum oxygen uptake for these crew members during their long-duration missions. Meanwhile, Aki Hoshide was reviewing all of the robotics operations alongside Joe Acaba on Monday, as the two of them would be at the robotic controls inside of the station's cupola for all of those activities. He was also packing and stowing some final items on board of HTV, as it was filled with trash and other disposable items before the release from the station. He was also helping Joe get a few items over to that Soyuz craft as well. And the commander of that Soyuz craft and commander of the space station, Gennady Padalka, on Monday was running through a descent simulation and consulting with teams on the ground over the entire equipment list and all the stowage and the items that will be going into the spacecraft when it comes back. Also taking some time out to do some work on a Russian experiment known as the Kolonovsky crystal, which looks to determine methods to control the dynamics of specialized crystal structures using magnetic fields under microgravity conditions. So utilizing that unique environment of the International Space Station to do some pretty groundbreaking physics work. Meanwhile, Sergei Revin, one of our other Russian cosmonauts who will be returning with Gennady Padalka, was taking some photographs for a microorganism experiment on board the International Space Station. A lot of the work going on this week has been wrapping up some of these microorganism and biological experiment studies, as many of those samples as can be fit into the Soyuz as possible will be returned home. Our third Russian cosmonaut, Yuri Malenchenko, was doing some television checkouts with Russian ground sites and also installing some video gear before moving on to do some routine replacements inside of the Russian toilet system. Moving on to Tuesday, Joe Acaba removing some of the lighting assemblies from inside of the Japanese HTV craft and also closing the hatch. And aside from that, he was installing the controller panel assembly on the Node 2, or the Harmony Node's common berthing mechanism, as they were preparing for the final unberthing of HTV the following day on Wednesday. Meanwhile, Sonny Williams again working with that VO2 max experiment on Tuesday, looking to still track any changes in her maximum oxygen uptake during the long duration mission. She was also working on the vestibule between Harmony and HTV, disconnecting some of the power jumpers that have been supplying power from the station to the vehicle while it was docked, and also installing some of the thermal blankets on the hatch that'll protect the station's hatch from any thermal loads during the undocking activity. And then meanwhile, she was assisted in that by Aki Hoshide on Tuesday, who was also closing out all of the interior prep work for the HTV by taking some video of the entire interior setup and also activating the reentry breakup recorder, which records different data points, as well as taking video throughout the HTV's descent through the atmosphere as it breaks up and eventually disintegrates harmlessly over the Pacific Ocean. Meanwhile, on Tuesday, Gennady Padalka was continuing his crew departure prep for that Soyuz landing and moving a few items into the craft, also setting up some equipment for a Russian immuno experiment that he would be participating in the following day, which looks to track any changes in the immune system response, which past studies have shown can actually decrease or weaken during long-duration space flights. So he was setting up some equipment for that. And also on Tuesday, Sergei Revin was actually doing his own blood draws for that immuno experiment and then stowing them inside of some of the cryogenic freezers on board, as well as gathering some more equipment for stowage in that Soyuz vehicle. And the third Russian cosmonaut, Yuri Malenchenko, on Tuesday was setting up and testing some proximity communications equipment gear, which consisted of an antenna switch box and a control panel for the European ATV vehicle, which remains docked to the aft portion of the Zvezda service module, one of three unmanned cargo craft currently docked to the International Space Station. You can see the full station makeup here. Only two unmanned cargo crafts currently docked, as the Japanese HTV was all the way on the left there, previously docked to Harmony, but ATV-3 you can see all the way in the back there. So Malenchenko setting up some communications and control panel gear for that vehicle on Tuesday. Moving on to Wednesday, which was HTV release day, Joe Acaba was setting up the robotic workstation inside of the cupola and performing the actual demate, which occurred with the commands being given at about 6:50 a.m. Central Time on Wednesday, and then eventually performing that HTV release as it prepared to depart the International Space Station. While all this was going on, Sonny Williams was closing out the vestibule for HTV and installing the final thermal covers, also taking over the final depress of the vehicle. This is what HTV looked like after it was demated from the Harmony module and was being released by the space station's robotic arm. The HTV vehicle, which carried 4.6 tons of cargo to the International Space Station, was released by this robotic arm, but then after within a few minutes of this release, an internal abort was triggered on board the HTV after it had slowly started to drift back towards the arm. Japanese flight controllers later acknowledged the most probable cause was what's known as a safety net software violation. So one of the limits on the cargo ship's thrusters was reached, possibly being induced by a push-off rate from that robotic arm's end. But the vehicle did exactly what it was supposed to do, and you can see it departing the International Space Station right here, moving a little bit faster than the traditional 1/10 of a meter per second, so sending it into a passive abort, but again, doing exactly as it was supposed to do as it was departing the International Space Station for the final time. So that robotics and HTV activity taking up much of the day on Wednesday as Joe Acaba and Aki Hoshide were standing by inside of the cupola. That HTV craft, which again carried up about 4.6 tons of cargo to the International Space Station, released and demated on Wednesday. So in addition to standing by the robotics controls on Wednesday, Aki Hoshide was responsible for closing out the vestibule alongside of Williams and installing the thermal cover and also the command panel that they used for any command necessities. Also taking some time out of his day on Wednesday to speak with the office of the Prime Minister of Japan. And then meanwhile, Gennady Padalka continuing work with that immuno experiment and also doing some final data takes for the Russian pneumocard, which looks to study the adaptation of the cardiovascular system of these astronauts during long durations of space flight. He's also working with the Russian Matryoshka experiment, which uses a number of dosimeters arrayed throughout a mannequin-sized object to study the radiation levels that these astronauts are subjected to throughout different points inside of the International Space Station. While that was going on, Sergey Revin was removing a few lights from inside of the Mini Research Module 2, also known as POISC, where their Soyuz craft is currently docked to. He was also doing some of that work inside of the Zvezda service module, and Yuri Malenchenko was assisting Gennady Padalka in deploying some of those dosimeters inside of Matryoshka, and also doing some routine maintenance on the Russian Electron system, which looks to generate oxygen for the astronauts' breathing atmosphere on board the station. Moving on to Thursday, Joe Acaba getting in some descent training alongside of Padalka and Revin inside of their Soyuz craft, and also gathering up some hardware for an activity he'll be doing today to remove and replace a fluid control pump assembly. Sonny Williams was working to do a removal and replacement of the oxygen generation system, similar to Electron, but over on the U.S. segment. And she was replacing its hydrogen sensor, and she also participated in a YouTube Space Lab event, which we'll bring you a little bit later in today's show, answering questions from Bill Nye, the science guy, and giving a pretty cool inside look and doing a few experiments that were selected for onboard the International Space Station. Meanwhile, Aki Hoshide taking some sound measurements onboard the station using acoustic dosimeters, which were placed throughout the station structure and are used to track sound loads throughout different portions. He was also performing some medical scans for the SPRINT experiment, which looks to study if high-intensity, low-duration workouts have any improved effect on combating a loss of pulmonary function and also muscle atrophy and bone density loss inside of these astronauts. Yesterday, Padalka was involved in descent drills and crew departure preps for most of his day. Sergey Revin servicing the cascade experiment. He was removing the bioreactor from the incubator and loading it on board of his Soyuz craft, that Soyuz TMA-04M spacecraft for eventual return. Also, Yuri Malenchenko was conducting periodic maintenance of the Russian harmful impurities removal system, one of the many hardware systems on board the International Space Station responsible for removing any impurities or potentially hazardous items from the astronauts' breathing air. All of that brings us to today's activities Friday, where Joe Acaba is performing that fluid control and pump assembly removal and replacement work that inside of the water recovery system. He'll also be reviewing the status of the contingency water containers used for any emergency or any unplanned refills of the water recovery system's supplies. Meanwhile, Sonny Williams is also working on some of the water systems on board the station, doing some maintenance on the potable water dispenser's beverage adapter, and then she'll be doing some SPRINT ultrasound scans of her own, which Hoshide was doing yesterday, again, doing some scans of her legs as they continue to track if this high-intensity, low-duration workout regimen has any different effects from the normally scheduled 2 hours a day of exercise that these astronauts generally take. Meanwhile, Aki Hoshide is working inside of the small payload rack and focusing on the aquatic habitat, which was brought up to the International Space Station on board that HTV-3 vehicle, which departed back on Wednesday. You can see the aquatic habitat here giving a a very unique test bed for tracking any biological experiments on different aquatic life in microgravity environments, which can have some very insightful results for life down here on Earth. Aside from that, he'll be removing and transferring some of those acoustic dosimeters over to the Soyuz 30S craft for return down to Earth. Then Commander Padalka will be packing up some gear inside of Soyuz and transferring some sensors from that Russian Matryoshka radiation experiment over to the Soyuz for return, while his Soyuz crewmate Sergei Revin will be doing some house cleaning work, cleaning up some of the dust collectors and fan screens, which help to constantly revitalize the astronaut's breathing atmosphere. And he'll also be gathering up some microbial samples from a few of the Russian experiments for return down to Earth. And our final Expedition 32 crew member, Yuri Malenchenko, today, immediately upon waking up, participated in the SPRUT experiment, which looks to track something known as orthostatic tolerance, or in much simpler terms, these astronauts' ability to stand upright and maintain proper balance upon their return to Earth. And aside from that, he was working on the biodegradation experiment on board the Russian segment, which is a pretty fascinating experiment that looks to investigate the initial stages of any bio deterioration of different surfaces and structural materials inside the station. And that'll help scientists and engineers understand what microorganisms are present on board the station and help develop effective methods of protecting future spacecraft surfaces, inventing new coatings and different antimicrobials. And with all these activities going on, as mentioned, three of our astronauts, Padalka, Revin, and Akaba, scheduled to depart from the International Space Station and land, bringing an end to Expedition 32 a little bit later this weekend on Sunday.